I got a new tripod, so I'm trying to make sure like all the measurements and everything are right on it. I think it looks, from what I can tell, pretty decent. Not bad. Not bad. It's a lot higher than my other one. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to Steely Dan, of course, with their song, Josie, off of their album, Asia. Which was released in, what, 1977, I think I said before? Hey, I got the year right. What do you know? Finally. It has been a very pleasant journey listening to this album, listening to all of these songs with you guys. Hopefully you enjoyed that as well. I've really been taken quite aback with Steely Dan, and I've really enjoyed their songs. So after this album, who knows where we'll go next? I don't know. You gotta stick around to find out. I hope that you guys are having a fantastic day. Thank you so much for continuing to watch these videos with me and to listening to the music with me, because it's nice to be able to listen to music with friends, discuss it down in the comments, and just all around have a good time. You can join me, speaking of which, in the comments. You can join me on Twitter, only if you're interested. This is Steely Dan with Josie. My internet went out. I knew. What a nice send-off for the album. What a nice send-off for the album. Sorry. I don't know why it went to Home at Last. I thought what was so cool about it was this really cool, funky beat. I mean, this is funk, right? The whole verse was funk. But when it transitioned into the chorus, those smooth keys that came in, those took it over the edge because it changed the mood from this rocky, funky beat into this almost glamorous kind of feeling when those keys came in. The horn section, when that came in, sounded like a little bit of big band, just like cut in half maybe, taking part of that half and putting it in Steely Dan's Josie. You got a little bit of a big band feeling, but just like I said, like a little bit. This is not big band, this is like average size band. Drumming was fantastic throughout the song, but especially in the break, maintaining a certain groove and a certain momentum, but not being afraid to come out the pocket a little bit and break out on the hi-hats, break out some nice jazzy fills. Perfect and beautiful drumming. And then you have that flawless guitar solo, maybe about a halfway in through the song, which it looks like was played by Walter Becker. And that was such a tasteful solo, wasn't it? Like, it was perfectly fit for the song. It was jazzy, it was smooth, it wasn't overplayed whatsoever. It fit right where it needed to be. And that's what made it come across so good. It felt effortless, it felt good, you can move to it. It's a great solo. The bass work is very spaced, but even though it plays pretty simply, it still grooves. The drums still moves. Everything about this continually improves. Listen to this transition with the keys. Here we go. Listen. See how that just elevates and changes the whole mood of the piece? I think that's really cool because they have this perfect foundation of funk. Perfect foundation. They excel at it. But it's with that change, that transition, with the added keys, that just move the song into a different aspect. And I like when songs do that. I like when songs change. It doesn't have to be this huge structural change. It doesn't have to be something that comes out of nowhere. No, the keys were very smoothly brought in, and yet they changed the whole song. They changed that whole section. But it still retains everything that they were doing before. It's still just as funky. The drum is still kicking it. The bass is still high end. And after this big chorus, listen to how they break it down. Drums, guitar, and bass killing it in this section. I love the wow. That's cool. I like that. I feel that this is a very nice ending to the album. I think that this just sounded like a fun song. Like I said, I mean, that's sometimes what you need. You just need some fun. The lyrics. We're gonna break out the hats and hooters when Josie comes home. We're gonna rev up the motor scooters when Josie comes home to stay. We're gonna park in the street, sleep on the beach and make it. Throw down the jam till the girls say when. Lay down the law and break it when Josie comes home. Who is Josie? I don't know. to be honest, it sounds like grandma coming home from the hospital because they say they're gonna rev up their motor scooters. And all I'm thinking of are like, I'm not thinking of like a motorcycle, I'll tell you that. Maybe it's someone getting out of jail. Maybe Josie is part of a motorcycle gang and she's like the fun part. She's like the party of the group. When she gets out of jail and she's coming home, you know, we're gonna celebrate. We're gonna rev the engines. We're gonna break bottles. We're gonna sleep on the beach. Like I said, this could all be. I don't think that this is what it is, but whoever this Josie is, sounds like a very fortunate person because they have some friends that are gonna have a crazy welcome home party. That's all I can say. I don't know what it's about, to be honest. all I can say is that yeah, they're gonna throw down this nice party. Hopefully there's some good food, and you know, we'll clean it up the pieces in the morning. Anyways, great closer to the album. It's not my favorite on the album. While I can admit that it does sound cool, especially that funk spirit that it has, it doesn't necessarily move me like some of the other songs on the album have moved me. But we'll talk about that later on an album review whenever I get to that. Of course, I want to know what you guys thought of this song. You can join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below. Hopefully you're having a nice day. Hopefully my tripod made this look, if not the same, better. And hopefully not worse. Did I say join me on Twitter in the comments? If not, you can join me on the comments down below and on Twitter. Have a fantastic night. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.